Hi fellow entrepreneurs, my name is Tepo Musieri. Welcome to our show. Today we'll be talking about the difference between output VAT and input VAT. So if you are a VAT vendor, you've already registered for VAT, you now have to submit VAT returns. And when you submit VAT returns, you need to understand there's output VAT and there's input VAT. If you are not an accountant or you don't come from a tax background, you'd ask yourself, what is output VAT and input VAT? So output VAT is the VAT that the owner of the business person or the supplier charges the customer, right? So when someone comes to buy from you, then the VAT that you charge them is called output VAT. You regard that as output VAT. So that's the VAT that you charge on sales, or rather on revenue. It depends on how you'd want to refer to it. And then input VAT is the VAT that the supplier has charged the customer. Or in this case, if you have a supplier, you are a business owner, you have a supplier, obviously you are a customer to that supplier. So the VAT that that supplier charges you, to them is output, like I explained. But to you now, it is input VAT. So meaning that when you submit your VAT 201 returns, right? You now have to disclose the VAT that you charged to your customers as output VAT, and you have to disclose the VAT that your suppliers charged you as input VAT. And now the difference that you're going to get, whether it is a negative or a plus. So if it's a plus, it means that it is a payable. The difference that you get when after doing your VAT control account is a plus, it means it is a VAT payable. If it is a negative now, meaning your input VAT were higher than your output VAT, now that becomes a VAT receivable. So SARS has to now pay that VAT back. But if it's a payable, you are the one who has to pay SARS that VAT. But we are going to discuss VAT payable and VAT receivable in detail in our next tutorial. I hope to see you in our next tutorial. Thank you.